President Museveni has written to the head of public service, Alex Mitala, instructing him to immediately fire the permanent secretary in the coveted energy ministry docket. Isabalija's exit, barely 9 months into his job, comes at the peak of a tumultuous spell in a ministry where intrigues and fights had crippled work, highly placed sources revealed. Speaking to NTV, Uganda Media Center Executive Director Ofono Pondo revealed why Isabalija was sacked.
Well, the president's letter does not give any reason why Dr. Stephen Isabalija had his contract terminated. Your guess can be as good as mine. But really, what is apparent is that perhaps he failed to meet the expectations of the appointing authority.
Other highly placed sources revealed that the immediate cause of his sacking was in regard to the $4.5 billion oil refinery deal where the young technocrat burnt his fingers. Earlier on this month, Isabalija revealed that an American and Italian consortium had been awarded the deal to build the refinery. In the Daily Monitor story published on August 7th, Isabalija is quoted saying the consortium had already proposed to government a financing approach and a path to establish, develop, and operate a commercially viable refinery company. However, China's Dongsong-led consortium, which scored 83.38% and came first in the evaluation committee, was aggrieved. The American-led Intercontinental Asset Holdings Consortium, which was awarded the deal, came second with 66.78% in the evaluation report. This is what prompted a meeting between officials from the Internal Security Organization and the president, effectively sealing the fate of Isabalija, sources reveal. Earlier on in June, the Director General of Internal Security Organization, Kabagambe, wrote a letter which raised the red flag over graft-related concerns in the award of the lucrative deal. In a letter seen by NTV, it raises concerns that the American and Italian consortium, Intercontinental Asset Holdings Assets, did not demonstrate availability of funds and lacks the operator for the refinery. With their clout and leverage as Uganda's leading providers of loans and grants, the Chinese protested about what they felt was an unfair award. It was only a matter of time left to rid Isabalija of his position. Only yesterday, the president appointed the director of Petroleum Directorate, Robert Kasande, to serve in acting capacity before he traveled to Equatorial Guinea. With quite a rich profile in public policy and management, Isabalija rose to prominence when he was appointed as board chairperson of the Uganda Electricity Generation Company Limited. Under his docket, he was given the role to inspect the construction of both Karuma and Isimba dams. This role would place him in a confrontation with the Permanent Secretary for Energy, Kabagambe Kaliisa. Isabalija would later win the battle of supremacy after he failed several dossiers, accusing Kaliisa of failing to supervise both Karuma and Isimba when they developed cracks. The president responded by sacking Kaliisa and replacing him with Isabalija last year. But in a ministry where Isabalija lacked technical expertise, institutional memory, and was surrounded by Kaliisa's surrogates, he was bound to get stuck in the proverbial quicksand. Emmanuel Mutaizibwa, NTV Tonight.